What's going on, YouTube? This is Necrostevo, and I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a, just like the slightest hint of a taste of how my ICL team did. Today I have a triple header, a Hydreigon header, or a Dodrio header if you're old school, against Latsu using my ICL team, and he's using actually his VGC team from 2014. Seeing his team, I noticed Talonflame was really good against basically everything on his team except for Rotom Heat. He brings out Gothitelle, which means I'm trapped in here. I did not want to take a Thunderbolt, so we're just going to U-turn out as I Mega Evolve for Mega Audino. I wasn't really fearing anything from either of those two Pokemon. He ends up Volt Switching as well, which sucks because he breaks my Focus Sash, but I did expect the electric attack, so I went ahead and went on into Breloom. That ends up working out pretty well for him. I go for Calm Mind just so I can take hits from Gothitelle better, hoping that it doesn't have Psy Shock instead of Psychic. And he ends up going for Trick Room. Now on this particular team, I have a lot of priority on the Pokemon that are faster, so the Trick Room doesn't end up mattering too much. I make a huge misplay here. I thought for sure he'd Psychic and go for the Gyro Ball. And so with that, I tried to Helping Hand my Breloom and attack the Ferrothorn. That didn't end up working out at all as he protects. I am able to take a Gyro Ball or two from Ferrothorn, even though those are super effective. And now that I'm finally able to bring in a Skyvalier, I can take Gothitelle right out, and now I can actually switch around pretty freely. Seeing the damage that Ferrothorn is doing with Gyro Ball, not really worried about it at all. And the plus side is now I can take advantage of his Trick Room. Because my Pokemon are slower than his, because I have a minus speed natured Escavalier. And so this Mega Horn actually does a pretty sizable chunk to Ferrothorn. And I just went for Draining Kiss, trying to hit the Rotom for something. I wanted to get back enough HP to live another Gyro Ball was the main point of going for Draining Kiss right there, while I didn't do very much damage. I could have also Helping Handed for Escavalier, but I was afraid he would Protect again, although he didn't really have any reason to. Here I knew that he was going to come out and go for Water Spout, and so I decided just to go for Helping Hand and boost the Mega Horn and hit the Blastoise as hard as I could. I figured I could take it out, but he ends up Protecting as I kind of end up wasting that turn. But that's okay though, because I'm able to Heal Pulse back up. He's trying to stall out the Trick Room now that my Pokemon are slower than his. The Trick Room was useful at first for him, but now it's working for me. And so here we see that Water Spout. I knew I could live it, and I missed the Helping Hand boosted Mega Horn. So not only am I going to lose Mega Audino, but also Escavalier cannot take another Water Spout. So that just sucks, because if I had lost my Audino after taking out, I think the Helping Hand boosted Mega Horn probably would have KO'd from that range. So that's just really unfortunate that I missed it. But then I could have, even if he did live it, I would have been able to clean up with Talonflame very easily. And then I would have, or I could have at least threatened the Ferrothorn with a Flare Blitz. So I would have had a lot more options. Now I'm forced to go for Brave Bird and only do half damage. And he takes out my Talonflame. And we see this unboosted Mega Horn damage on this turn. Just seeing how much damage that did, I was able to take it out from right around half with stat boost. I don't know. I just really feel like, unless he was more bulky than I thought he was, I would have been able to take him out. So I ended up losing the first of our first to three match there. But that's okay. We're going to make some adjustments. We see in this match, I'm going to end up bringing Aegislash instead, while he actually ends up bringing the same four. Because why change it if it worked out for you? But Aegislash actually is going to work out well for me, because I can use Wide Guard against his Mega Blastoise using Water Spout. So that, I think, is just going to work out generally better. Also, if I can coax his Rotom Heat into going for the Fire-type move, I will get my Weakness Policy activated. Here, I'm just going to go for a Helping Hand boosted Shadow Ball. Gothitelle does not often carry Protect, and so I just wanted to blow it away right at the beginning of the battle, rather than given an opportunity to set up Trick Room or be annoying or anything like that. Now I can switch around freely as well. He burns my Aegislash, but that is precisely why I don't use a physical Aegislash in VGC. It kind of just attracts burn, so no point in bringing something that'll be crippled. And this way, of course, I can utilize its special attacking stat and not have to worry about being crippled. So here I'm just going to go for King's Shield. I figured he would go for Water Spout, but at the same token, I didn't want to leave it in attack mode I don't know. I knew that I could take a water spout with my, I don't know. But I made a misplay there. I went for Calm Mind instead of just, either just attacking or something. I don't know. I really should have just gone for the attacking move. But here I'm going to Wygarde because I figured he's just going to water spout again. He goes for Overheat. It misses Aegis Slash, but with minus two and I'm in shield form, it actually would have been more beneficial for him to hit me that turn because he would have activated my weakness policy and he would not have done very much damage at all. But since now I've managed to knock off some of the HP of that Blastoise with a Draining Kiss, I get some HP back. I weaken the Water Spout, just generally good in every direction there. Here he finally activates my weakness policy as he knocks me down really, really low. I went for Draining Kiss, trying to just keep on whittling away at the Blastoise. Unfortunately, I don't quite hit the Blastoise. I kiss a very prickly durian in the form of Ferrothorn. I take a ton of recoil damage for that kiss. It's kind of like kissing someone with a beard that they don't really take care of, and it's just all prickly and gross rather than being nice and soft. And I've never had a beard myself. I don't want a beard. But I'm just saying, that's probably how it would be. Fortunately, I am able to hang on with 1 HP. I had a choice here. I could heal pulse up, but I really was hoping that he would predict the King Shield and leave my Aegis Slash alone, because if I King Shielded, then he wouldn't be able to switch out or anything like that. He also could have had Leech Seed, I guess. That's a thing. But either way, though, I end up losing both of my Pokemon this turn, which really sucks. Fortunately for me, I did bring Breloom again, and I also brought my Talonflame. Unfortunately, he carries Fake Out on his Mega Blastoise. I did not see that coming. I am able to just wipe out the Ferrothorn, but that does mean he broke my Focus Sash, and it's really going to be down to the number of hits that I get from Bullet Seed, because I have to attack his Rotom with my Talonflame at this point, just because I have to keep pressure on it. I can't let it hit my Breloom with a Fire Attack, and I can't let it hit my Talonflame with an Electric Attack. So I have to keep the pressure on. Fortunately, I do hit all the times I need to KO the Blastoise. I hit all 3 times, which is great. You have a certain amount of percentage chance to hit, and so it doesn't need to come down to that 50-50. Because since I took out the Blastoise, there's no way you can win, basically, because you can only KO one of my 2 Pokemon, and I have super effective moves for both, basically. Now, in this third match, we see that he's bringing Staraptor. Most Staraptor, when you see them in VGC, are either Scarfed or Banded. He also switched up and brought Hydreigon, which is appropriate because we had a Hydreigon header, best of 3. I once again led off with Audino and Aegis Slash, definitely just expecting a Fake Out here right in the beginning. And I know that he's probably going to Dark Pulse. I was really hoping that I didn't get flinched because I knew I had a good idea of what he was going to do here. But unfortunately, I can't use the Helping Hand to get the boost. But with the Weakness Policy, I'm able to put a huge amount of damage on the Blastoise, which is just amazing. I completely nullify that Water Spout for the most part. Now I don't have to deal with that. He ends up switching out into Staraptor. I'm happy that he switched on this turn when I don't care about the Intimidate. Breloom, of course, and Talonflame would not like the Intimidate. I ended up King Shielding just to try to get some priority back on my side of the field. I didn't want to take any chances. Now that I have my Weakness Policy activated, I really wanted to keep Aegis Slash on the field, because of course if I switched out, then I would no longer have access to that +2 special attack boost. Now something really, really special happens here. I end up King Shielding basically 2 times in a row there, because I knew that he was probably just going to Brave Bird and try to knock out the Aegis Slash. Not only does that give me an opportunity to heal pulse up, but it also drops the attack of his Staraptor, so he's forced to switch back out. And I knew he was forced to switch back out there. He ends up protecting with Ferrothorn, and I just ended up going for Draining Kiss, trying to put some damage on Staraptor. I figured if he switched out, he'd probably go into Blastoise for Death Fodder, but that ends up working out amazingly because I hit Hydreigon on the way in. And I still have, of course, my +2 boost. I'm able to heal pulse and get Aegis Slash's HP all the way back up. I was really, really fortunate to get those King Shields in a row like that. That's pretty hard to do. Every time, of course, you use King Shield or Protect, the chance of the next one working is cut in half. So, first one's guaranteed, then 50%, then 25%, and it just keeps on going down like that. So, he ends up switching out both of his Pokemon, bringing back in Staraptor. I think he was trying to predict where I would use Shadow Ball. And he does predict it correctly, as I did try to just shadow ball the Ferrothorn. But since his Blastoise is out of the picture now, he just has Hydreigon in the back. And outside of hitting the Ferrothorn, I don't have any reasons to really go for the shadow ball anymore. So at least now that I don't have to worry about that, I can use Flash Cannon with a little bit more impunity, and a Draining Kiss and Flash Cannon combination will take out the Staraptor. He ends up protecting with Hydreigon immediately when he comes back in. I just went for King's Shield, expecting him to want to go for the Fire-type move. And with Heal Pulse, again, I'm able to put myself at max HP, which means I can once again live a Dark Pulse from the Hydreigon. I guess he predicted me to go ahead and go for that in the way he did, but it really just set me up for a good solid position here in the end game, because now I'm able to use Shadow Ball against the Ferrothorn, and with what I have in the back, which is Breloom, I will be able to Mach Punch either one of these Pokemon. Even though he got a power with critical hit, it's not going to matter now, because now I can just take out whatever. Hydreigon is obviously the bigger threat here, so we're going to focus on that, just because he kind of lacks a little bit of offensive presence with his Ferrothorn. And of course, with that, I could have just Mach Punched my way to victory. So that's going to be the end of that triple header, that Hydreigon header. And kind of giving you guys a hint as to how the team ends up working together with these ICL matches. I think I had one more match that I'm going to be throwing in there as well. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed. Be looking forward to some more battles with this team. And I will talk to you guys later. Bye-bye now.